kita bawa apa ni artis penyanyi terkenal Dato' Francisca Peter bersama santai bersama Goki segmen minggu ini. So welcome to the show. I'm super
Thank you.
happy to have you, friend.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm very, very happy to be here. Memang.
So how you feel dari dulu dari sekarang kan ada banyak beza tau, Kak Friend. Like sekarang banyak
berbeza tu. Okay, berbeza tu umur sudah meningkat. Okay, and then other than that, dari segi music, I think music tu memang dah sudah macam evolve. You know, kalau kita kata lagu dulu, dia punya arrangement ke style 70s, sekarang sudah pulang ke zaman kini, now.
Yeah.
You know, dia punya style, you know. And then 80s also coming back, begitu juga. So, I think macam full circle lah. So, dulu, sekarang also I think semua pun jadilah, you know.
Dia macam benda tu after the COVID, I rasa untuk semualah, tak kira dalam industri ke semua, it's a impact. Ada yang dapat a great impact dari after the COVID. That mean kita senang digaul. Most of the time kita nampak artis semua kat dalam social media, dia orang share apa yang dia orang buat kat rumah. Everything like banyak top-top artis juga. So they spend most of the time dekat kat sini, join with the, you know, eratan itu, that is a really awesome. Kalau kita dah
yes.
jumpa ke friend peminat kita ni, I mean, kita kena pergi how to so how to say the show ke event ke, yeah, this
ada
is
yang
a very a good
baik, I think ada yang baik and also ada yang tak not so yeah. baik. So lah, masa COVID mula that time and the lockdowns and all, sebab kita sudah macam biasa kan selalu keluar buat show, you know, events, you know, concerts, and then suddenly whoop, nothing, lockdown,
yeah.
stay home, then it's like macam mana tak ada kerja, means macam mana, sure risau kan. Bukan semua
yeah.
artis pun kaya, setengah pun it's like a struggle. Yang kalau kaya tu so maybe maybe 5% or 10% yang very very kaya, but the rest are still seperti, you know, I'm not that way. So I love what I do, so I memang suka kerja, I love singing, you know, so that's I punya bread and butter. So saya memang mau terus menyanyi, buat show and all that. But walaupun masa lockdown tu pun it was hard, but I know that our TV stations pun baik juga, sebab diorang pun cari satu jalan untuk kita cari makan lah, you know, to do,
yes.
to show our gift, our talent, share music. So semua pergi online.
Mm-hmm.
And masa tu pun macam orang macam saya ni, I'm not so savvy punya kan IT thingy. So but and then I suddenly kena belajar lighting, sound. So I kena, the lucky thing masa tu the lockdown, they lockdown masih, but two people boleh keluar juga beli barang kan. So I went to shop, beli lights, beli the microphones, you know, and then the little punya gadget lah, you know, and then buat macam studio dalam bilik, you know, that kind of thing. So belajar juga everything, and then buat makeup sendiri, tak ada makeup artist, and I memang teruk, tak pandai dengan makeup, you know. Macam ni, izin kepada rakyat, hikmat diberi penuh taat, sama bekerja, sama berusaha, setia berhikmat untuk semua, rela berkorban apa saja, amanah bangsa tetap dijaga, kami berikrar penuh setia untuk agama, bangsa dan negara. May we always have peace in Malaysia and love for one another.
The Wash Setia. Yes, guna silen. Yes. Ini peminat dari Switzerland, I think Swiss. The Voice. Oh, okay. How, Kafren, you manage The Voice? You know, feel like you bring back to the old. Oh my God.
I think like you love something, like you love what you do. So you get a real excitement plus the nervousness. Semua sekali, kan?
Yes.
But you love what you do. Same with me. I love what I do. I sing in my car. Nobody can hear me outside. I don't sing in my bathroom though. Toilet memang tak nyanyi. But sometimes I dalam bilik I just go and rakam some, you know, short verses here and there. I do my own little reels, you know, short ones. And then I bagi my sister, my manager Bibiana and our admin guy. And they all work together and they upload yang mana-mana I suka. I pilih lah lagu yang saya suka. You know, I always go for melodies, strong melodies. Yeah.
So that's the thing. You apa ni? How to say? Suara tu masih ada. So dua tiga tips, Kak Fran. How to manage to maintain dia punya suara tu? Bagaimana kita kena buat practice dalam siapa yang evergreen voice? Of course, she is.
I don't know lah. I tak tahu macam mana nak cakap. So because why? Sometimes. You know, sometimes we all have good days pun. Ada good days, ada bad days juga. As penyanyi juga. Because kita memang bukan robot, you know. Kita memang manusia biasa. So, kalau kita jatuh sakit, sure, sometimes nyanyi aja, kenapa dia nyanyi macam tu? You know, I can hear people sometimes they criticize this artist, that artist that I'll say, ayah, maybe she's sick lah, you know. Don't be so mean, you know. Or maybe she's had something going on in a personal life. Yeah. Sometimes as artists, we are also very delicate. We are delicate people. We are also sensitive also because kita tak ada macam peluang untuk to be ourselves. When we go out, our fans look at you a certain way. Yeah. And we have to carry ourselves a certain way pun. You know, we have to be responsible juga. Because youngsters look up to us, you know, thinking, oh, kita minat dia, dia memang baik, you know. So, there are certain things. But when, kalau kita on our own time, you know, we can chill, relax with our, kita punya family or close friends, then it's a different story. We can be ourselves. But when we have taken this responsibility as an artist, walaupun kita cinta apa yang kita buat, this is a passion, we still have a responsibility in public, you know.
Yes.
So, and also sleep is very important. I always beritahu orang, but since COVID, COVID really is teruk. I tell you, COVID needs a slap. And masa ini pun masih ada orang also still getting sick and all that. But during COVID, I tell you, our sleep was really koyak, man. Don't know what day, so like vampires, tengok TV lah, tak boleh keluar lah, this one, that. And then you're sleeping like a vampire. Your daytime, you're sleeping. Nighttime, you're up like crazy, kan? Yeah. Everybody was going to, and then some people makan, and you order makan, and every day. You know, I remember there was one guy who did some video of, yo, makan lagi, jam makan aja hari-hari. So, I think the sleep is very important. And some people, of course, when they kena COVID also, a lot of people went through difficult times. Their lungs became weaker, you know, and they had to. Some did not recover. Some, you know, macam sederhana sahaja, you know, dia punya kesihatan. And then they still have to sing, so they manage. And I always think that it is okay kalau kamu harus turunkan key untuk nyanyi lagu you, lagu hit. I think it's okay. I don't think people should pressure someone, alah, dia tak boleh nyanyi lah, dia turunkan key. Don't talk like that. Because suara tu memang ada, cuma dia turunkan key. So, it is okay asalkan dia masih boleh nyanyi lagu dia, lagu hit dia. We have to be also kind, you know, sometimes. Because this can happen to anyone. It can also happen to me, walaupun today I'm still singing the same, you know, as I was long time ago, but who is to say what will happen tomorrow? So we need to be kind. kita harus
We have a question here. Ada soalan kat sini. Please tell us woman that always inspire you as a person. Of course, for me, mak I.
Me too. My mother and my grandmother. My grandmother and my mother. They inspire. There are a few women who inspired me, actually. One is my friend's mother in UK. And of course, my mother, my grandmother. Both my grandmothers from my bapa punya side and my mom's side. And there are some women that I also look up to, you know, and also, Saint Mother Teresa, you know. I look up to a lot of people who sacrifice their own personal needs and life untuk tolong orang yang dalam kesusahan. And we must recognize and acknowledge this. And mothers are amazing lah, mothers, you know, they really, I mean, I look at my mom, she was there with us, the children, all the way, you know, sampai hari ini, so kita jaga dia balik, my mom.
Betul, the mother is, first of all, I think banyak orang ingatkan kita ni artis, you know, we are dalam industri, so kita dah macam, tapi for us, like we know everything, family first, of course, mother, nobody can, masa kita tired tu dari balik dari shooting ke, dari apa-apa, the first people, you dah makan ke?
Yes.
the love, you know, the love.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know about the modern days today lah. But sometimes modern days, so I pernah tengok juga. They're not great because everyone is working, kan? Husband working, wife working. You come back, it's like, go do your own thing, man. You know? I'm sorry. You know? It's like, I say, you know, you can feel, you know, there's so many instances macam couples, young couples especially, kan? Aku baru balik lah. Nak suruh aku buat teh lagi, you buatlah untuk I, you know, that kind of thing. You know, I mean, these are little things lah, bukan semua macam tu, but it's like that. But yes, my mom's time, I think she raised us begitu juga. So when my family is around, we tend to say, nak minum teh ke? And I'm going to make, you know, I'm going to make and do this and do that, you know. So it's like normal for me, for us, my mom, you know, it's normal for the girls in my family.
So that's really sweet lah. How to say, like nobody can replace a mother love. That is different, sangat unik tu. Okay, kita ada question also. Who is Dato idola singer? Idola.
Really very hard to tell because there are so many. And I cannot really like, because semua penyanyi pun lain juga. Dia ada dia punya own style, you know. And I was thinking, how to say that, oh, I like this singer, I like that singer. But they are different, you know. And I mean, I suka penyanyi yang ada balada yang strong, you know, strong balance. That type penyanyi lah. I like penyanyi with a big voice. Big voice, banyak emosi, you know, how they bawa lagu itu, you know, that you they can actually, with the lyrics, they can actually like take you to another planet, and then they can bring your feelings out and you actually would cry, you know. That's the type of singing. And there are few like that, but not many. But there are, as well as I've had a lot of hurtful experiences too, but it made me stronger, you know, stronger, not in the sense stronger, but it made me careful. Sometimes too careful also, it, you know, I don't know. You know, and I became so careful that I think I'm sometimes overly careful. Terlalu careful. And then sometimes I want to just macam, you know, just be free, you know, let my head down, you go crazy a bit. But susah juga, you know, it's hard. But there are many instances yang bagus. A lot of good things happen in, you know, as I've come this far. So many awards, so many things I've got achieved.
Things so I
Susah nak cakap.
From,
Yeah.
From the, we sharing the good things. From the good things, the incident yang Kak friend pun didn't expect that. I'm in the top list. My song in the top list. So
okay, that excitement memang ada. Like tak sangka lagu Setia akan jadi begitu. Tak sangka Sekadar Di Pinggan will be the first music winning song. And then tak sangka Sekadar also became the first ASEAN winning song also in whole of ASEAN.
Yes.
Masa tu. And so that was it. That was the first and I think the last, I think, you know. And there's so many others also incidents also. Banyak lagi. I also recorded in the States, you know, the single for this jazz saxophonist. So a lot of things lah. Banyak. A lot of things. A lot of stuff. And then, of course, the awards that I got, you know. Anugerah this and that, you know. And then my fans lah. I think I owe it to the fans, my family, my fans. And masa I balik here, so my sister has been a very, you know, sometimes people always say managers, manager don't want to deal with the manager. It's not about that. Mm-hmm. Artists cannot deal for themselves.
Yes.
Because we are like a product. And then we are not good at, you cannot be dealing and then also go on stage. Because sometimes if something don't go right ke, then kita pula. Macam mana nak nyanyi kan? We will be worried about things and all that. So, my sis has been an amazing person, a great gatekeeper, a good manager. She does all she can for, you know, for me. And I'm very, very grateful to her for so many years now. And fans lah. And the fans, you know, they have been by my side. From before, now, from their grandparents to their parents to the children now, they know who I am. So I'm very grateful.
Yes, of course. We love you, Kak friend. Of course.
Thank you.
And terima Dato dulu dengan Roy era 80s.
Okay.
So I'd like to share something about it.
Okay. After masa I nyanyi pub, masa I mula that time nyanyi pub, you know, then came to one day the band that I was with pecah lah. So then I had to work lah because I had to work to earn a living to support the family kan. Uh-huh. Masa tu. So Roy masa tu was looking for a singer. Dia main organ dalam satu hotel kat KL. And so it was called Merlin Hotel that time. So he was looking for a singer. So I needed a job. So we went there and got together. And so we became Roy and Fran, you know. Masa tu nyanyi dekat hotel. Then one day, this is the story that ramai mungkin tak ramai yang tahu. Tapi one day, the late Datuk Sudirman, he came to the hotel to have his supper. So malam tu dia datang, saya nyanyi lagu ni, lagu lama lah, it's a 50s punya song. My mom loves these songs. Lagu tu berjudul what is that? Frankie, and penyanyi tu Connie Francis. It's a 50s punya song, and I love those kind of songs. So I was singing that song. Then the late Sudirman, Datuk Sudirman sitting there, and he said, "You." And after that, the next few nights, dia malam-malam datang makan supper. And then you ask me, "Friend, can you please sing me that song?" You know, and I'll sing it. Then one night, after so many months, dia datang. One night, dia bawa EMI punya boss.
Okay.
He brought her, Mrs. Bay. And then they sat down there and then he said, "This is the girl I'm telling you about." Because aku nyanyi lagu tu untuk dia. So then next thing you know, they called, and then next thing you know, that's how Roy and Fran started lah. He said, "Fran, come sit down. I want you to meet Mrs. B." So I sat. Then after he said, then Roy plays, and after they decided, you know, since there were no duos that time masa tu, they had, they were, I think, there were no duos at that time, masa tu. So they wanted something new, and so they decided, okay, why don't we make them as a duo, you know, rather than, you know, let's make them as a duo. It's a good timing.
Betul.
So we became Roy and Friend lah. Thanks to the late Sudirman. Thanks to him.
Yes, of course. Dia, nah. Kita nanti pasal dia banyak. Kita punya late Sudirman. You know, it's a really a person attached to, very close, attached to the many, many fans.
Yes.
Many, many, I rasa banyak orang kat Malaysia.
Yes. He's a big fan. When dia tengok talent, he sees, he likes something. He's there, he was kind lah. Was very kind of him.
Agree. So kita ada banyak persoalan kat sini, banyak question, a lot of loves. Thank you for sending a love to Kak Fran, and thank happy you. To see you all in a live. So banyak question kat sini. Hi Kak Fran, saya meminat Kak Fran dari berduit dengan Rosta Sister Maria. Oh wow. Banyak ini dari.
Yeah.
Dan gandingan bersama my favorite, gandingan bersama Dato' apa ni, Jamal Abdillah also. That song is a very, I love that song. I love that song.
So many people, and you know what, I've been singing it a few times already with him since last year. We've been doing some shows together, and I also sang for his concert in Singapore with you know, to sing the duet with him. And so this song, we've been doing quite a few events together that we have to sing the song together. Plus, sometimes even other places like private events. I was in Sarawak recently also. I sang with one of the people there. You know, he's an organizer somehow, and he wanted to sing that song with me. So everywhere I go, people will ask to do that duet, Kehebatan Cinta, you know, with them. So I do it lah. Yeah.
Goki pun ada ada update Kak Fran punya banyak yang klip-klip lagu dekat social media. Goki punya dekat TikTok. So I see banyak lagu ni memang sweet punya lagu. Kalau both of them join, it's a very sweet pair. Yes. Of this one, you know.
Yeah.
The CD,
you know. It's a chemistry also. There is a chemistry pun he and I. Because we are like, we are, he'll make a joke lah this time. He's very witty. He's got a great sense of humor, Dato' Jamal. So and when we see each other, we all have like this, we are like family, you know. We are very close, like brotherly, sisterly love. Yes. And there's no like macam, you know, funny thingy or whatever. So when we're on stage, there's this chemistry, it's amazing. People say, unbelievable, these two, you know, because we are affectionate because the song is so beautiful, you know. And then the crowd see it also, they feel like they are part of this care and this kindness and love around, you know. So the audience always loves things like that. Beautiful song. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's the thing. Saya meminat Kak Fran dari berduit dengan Rostan Sister a lot. Because masa tu Goki ada clip video, I mean dari RTM punya sources tu, Goki ada update. Masa tu Kak Fran tengah nyanyi. So it's unexpected, you know, surprise dari dari Dato' Jamal Abdillah tu. So it's very nice lah masa tu. Yeah.
Everybody banyak. Everyone talks about that, don't they?
Yes.
A lot of people exactly. Talk about that, you know, that scene, you know, he's there running, coming, you know, yeah.
Itu Goki ada update dekat social media.
You all are there, you know, all you all are so, you know, you guys keep me going. You know, you guys keep me going.
Yes.
You keep me alive through my music. You all are keeping me alive, you know,
yes.
And I'll continue to do what I can. And I know ramai pun peminat juga tanya saya, kalau boleh buatlah concert. Of course, I would love to do a concert. We are hoping that, you know, if there are any sponsors out there, you know, they're willing to sponsor. Yes, I would gladly do it. You know, we just need a good sponsor and we will do it. If we have the people, we have, but we just need a good sponsor. And also, you know, there are a lot of macam, also there are a lot of people want me to do new song, and nowadays semua buat single. So All this ramai juga still all on the pipeline. Semua tunggu saya. Tunggu saya. I'm coming. Wait, it's coming. I'm gonna be doing it. Wait, it's coming. But I want to give my fans the best. Eka.
Okay, that is happy news lah untuk fan ka friend punya fan semua, siapa yang tengah tengok ni. And as I told you, kita dah dekat penghujung live. Okay, dalam 5 tahun ini, apa kak Fran rasa akan we can expecting dalam industri music ni sebagai seorang penyanyi Malaysia? Uh-huh. Apa kak Fran, how you feel about that?
I hope that there will be macam, you know, that we will have more platforms for our Malaysian artists. More. To bring us all out, whether you're matured artists or young artists or so. But, you know, the hope that our country will look up to our musicians and our singers. Mm-hmm. Give us more, you know, more. Help us more. To feel proud that you also have your own artists, musicians, you know, and why not, you know, because every country has theirs, they're all proud of theirs. Yeah. We should also be proud of ours and not think like, oh, when they need them, then, but you know, we are more concerned about who's coming here and that. It's not to say that we are not fans of international acts and things like that. We are too. We are all fans of someone, kan? So, but on the other hand, this is us. We have a lot of performers here too, whether you're whatever the race or so. But there are so many talented people. So let's try to help our own as well. Always remember, charity begins at home. A lot of people are going through difficult times. Mm-hmm. And, you know, some are still not doing so well as artists, you know, as musicians. And we have to find and give them a platform.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So,
more work. Many, yeah.
Yes, exactly. Support each other, help each
exactly.
other. That's the benda.
Yes.
Grow each other. I rasa benda ni kalau kita follow mesti I rasa Malaysia.
Love lah, you gotta love you gotta love.
Yeah.
Love us like how we would love you when we perform, you know, we want to give you, you know, the nice, the best, you know, and when you give us that much, it would be the mutual thing, you know, it's like treat people with kindness, we too, you know, it's both ways, you know, with love, the same.
Betul. So it's so sweet of you. As I told you, you are such a very a friend. You memang sweet punya orang lah.
Always. I am so kind lah, don lah. Shy ni now.
Betul. You know, thank always you. A positive. How you, whatever is it, you move always. You always keep your things like very very. A positive, you know, so that is supposed to be. Semua orang kena follow like how to say like idola yang ada orang banyak kata, Kak Frank, you are my idola, you know, something like that. Tadi nampak ada
yes.
banyak orang ada buat komen kat sana tu. So
benda thank ni you semua, lah semua.
Yeah, we still love you. Wherever we dekat Malaysia, kat mana-mana lah. Memang we still love you till now. You give us a biggest impact in music industry. And begitu, I have to say, not in the Malay also, in the Tamil also, we have a fans.
Thank you. You see, one day I'll record a Tamil song. I have recorded a Tamil song. It was for an uh-huh. NGO album, but, you know, it's a gospel one. And but one day, yes, I would like to. I've sung some for like shows, like, you know, here and there, little big one, short ones. Uh-huh. But one day I'd like to record a Tamil song. Because I think it's now it's pretty amazing. South Indian music is, and also movies. Oh my God, it's out of this world. You know.
Okay, how you feel about Malaysian any Tamil movie song that you Malaysian Tamil song that you heard?
I think because we've always been listening and watching movies and listening to songs in the movies and. And there are some really, really awesome songs, you know. I say, oh my gosh, the singing, ayo, it's so beautiful. And the movie, it's just out of this world. I can't remember the name. There's one particular song I really like, but oh my gosh, I can't remember the name. I wish I could. That's so terrible. You know? But I love that song. I can hear it in my mind, but I can't remember the
You can't remember the artist, but can you sing for us?
Oh, no, I cannot. The song was sung beautifully. This guy had the most awesome voice. It's because it's that you know, the classical kind of Indian singing joined with a commercial tone. Oh my word, it's out of this world. You know, you suddenly listen to songs like that, and then suddenly you feel. I say, what have I been listening to all these years? You know, it's that kind of feeling, you know. And of course, the movies that now that I've seen so many amazing South Indian movies. It can be Telugu, Malayalam. It can be Tamil. What is this? Kannada, you know, speaking whatever. There's so many dialects, right? And I was thinking, this movie. Movies, they're killing me, man. They're killing me. They're so amazing. Out of this world, the dialogue is ridiculous. The dialogue is like, I don't even see the Western scripts like that. You know, the storylines, the cinematography is outrageous. The cinematography is like, I don't know from where, but they are so amazing.
So I'm so happy to have you tonight. Banyak benda yang kita share.
Thank you so much for having me.
I hope you love the life tonight. Thank you so much for coming and joining.
Yes. I'm thrilled. I will come back to you again if you call me. This has been wonderful. And all of the fans and your fans, including mine, thank you for showing up tonight, you know?
Exactly. So that's the thing. Before we kita na end of the life, dalam kita dah ujung life sekarang. So Kafrena, anything you want to Kafrena share dekat Kafrena punya peminat and even for everybody. So apa yang Kafrena cakap, anything you can say.
Love, protect the children, and love, try to help and love your aging parents. Sometimes they can be difficult, but you try to be patient with them. You know, can not be easy, especially those who are macam caregivers. Yang penjaga untuk whether it's children ke atau orang tua ke, your parents, be kind lah, try to lah, yeah. And then sebab dengan apa yang tengah terjadi di seluruh dunia ni sekarang, also even at home sometimes tragedies, try not to let that become personal. Try to still fight for peace, fight for love for one another, respect and the unity, so that our country will be an amazing country, to make it so great, Malaysia, for us Malaysian first.
Betul. So happy. A lot of things kita share, as I told you.